Welcome back. So today we're continuing into chapter 5. Oh, it looks like this game has been updated, version 6405. That's exciting. Alright, so... last we left off, Tomcat was very willing and eager to help us in pursuit of something. I do not recall what, so Tomcat, you got anything to tell us?
Hey there. I'm a little busy.
Never mind. Turing, tell us where we are.
We've already been through a lot together, haven't we?
Oh, sure we have. In fact, yeah, the end of last stream, Tomcat and I had some conversation about you, Turing. Not that I'm going to tell you right now, but it was good to get a glimpse into some of Tomcat's backstory.
We're so close to you.
So our next objective is sentient AI. Good for you. Alright. Yeah. Just as a reminder, Turing was the same guy who broke our laptop. Lappy's still broken. So we actually have to go out into the outside world.
Ready to head out?
Not particularly, because I forget what it is we're supposed to do. But sure, why not? We have... Oh, just one destination. Kos IO Corp. Oh, yes we are.
Who knew a Parallax data center operated on the same KCOP coalition block as Augmented Eye all along?
Oh, well, I mean, we could kind of reason that given that, like, all the mega corporation technology, whatever stuff is all on this one block. Actually, the word they used is conglomerate, so that would probably be the most accurate term. But yeah, Parallax data center on the same coalition block seems pretty... I mean, that seems crazy, because Parallax doesn't need to have a data center in the middle of the city. Why would they do that? So yeah, we're actually searching for Turing's source code so we can learn more about his origin. Real... Oh, yeah, I guess it is.
The building we're looking for is over there, to the left.
Oh, to the left?
We should try to finesse our way in.
Well, I am the king of finesse.
We don't want to alert Parallax to our actions before we make our main assault on their server complex.
Like, yeah, I'm the king of stealth. And as such, I approve of us talking about this wide out in the open while other people are driving and walking by. Great move, Turing. But okay, sure. Let's go left. Maintenance person. He's pretty idle for someone who's probably on the clock. It's probably why he's idle.
I wish I actually had something to work on right now. But it is what it is.
You could go work on that weather bot we broke. Oh, get some more plants here. Actually, we looked at these already. How much would it cost for your landlord to put a plant like this in front of the apartment? A lot. He probably wouldn't do it if it were free. And you got another planter. The fern almost overflows from its wall-mounted holder, making it look like a featureless plastic head with green anime hair. All these plant holders look pretty spiffy. It's safely enclosed in its isolated ecosystem. Alright, let's barge through the door. Oh!
Sorry, this building isn't open to the public.
Then why did you put it in the downtown area?
If you're looking for the offices where we hold interviews, that's over on Bush and Lebanon.
Oh, well, fine.
But you may want to wait till after the holidays. I don't think anyone's around till 2065.
Oh, that's right. We're at the end of the year.
Let's go.
Okay.
We need some way past that receptionist.
Yeah, I say we... Oh.
Perhaps we can make ourselves appear to be here on more official business somehow. Like we're on duty.
Can't I just pull out my stunner and shoot him?
No one ever tries to stop you if you look like you belong.
Oh, no, 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 this is not a protest. No, I'm just trying to use their new guidelines, you know? So we're going to see if we get quality options or not. Alright, so you start with a nice enough discussion, but this truck wouldn't stop asking if it looks ugly in this paint color. And maybe if you could give it an oil change and a new tire. Now, have you heard of a window cleaner? This isn't a maintenance truck, but it's a high maintenance truck. Alright, let's steal it.
Maintenance uniform.
Oh, nice.
What do you think you're doing? Get out of there.
King of stealth. Oh, I've already got quality options. That's awesome.
Oh, drat. We'll have to find a way to distract him, or we'll never get our disguise. I hate to cause civil disorder again, but he doesn't seem to be too occupied
with
fixing anything.
Huh. Yep.
Maybe we should find a way to keep his hands busy?
Yeah.
Let's look around.
Okay. I can't use items on the truck or the van. Let's keep pestering him.
I service all the electrical work on this entire block.
Oh, well, thanks for the information. So I just have to cause an electrical issue somewhere. Say, like, here? Let's poke the welcome sign. It's not mine. Alright, let's zap the welcome sign. Oh!
Yikes, that was flashier than I expected. Hurry, we don't want to be caught standing.
Maybe you don't want to be caught standing there. Here, let's go bug him. Sup, dude?
Oh, cripes. The damn sign shattered again?
Yeah, it did. Oh, I guess, anyway. Let's take some maintenance uniforms, change into them. Great idea. I have an even greater idea. I have a greater idea. Let's go bug maintenance dude again while we're dressed up as a maintenance dude. Wow, really? He doesn't care. Alright, let's go in the other... Fine, fine. I guess we have to progress the plot. So, in we go.
Hey, what's going on outside? I thought I heard a bang.
Oh, that was me. Transformer overloaded. Nothing to worry about.
Huh? Yeah, okay. Are you new? I'm not sure I've seen you around before.
Yeah, I just got hired.
Well, I need to see your bag. This is a secure building.
Look, here's my badge. You should check out.
What? That clearly isn't you in that picture.
Oh, I'm so caught. All right, noted. No, I mean, we wouldn't have been given it if that we weren't supposed to use it. Yeah, sure, why not? Alright, fine. Wait. Let's use the desk. Oh. Alright, our handprint has been absorbed. Okay. Oh. Wait, are we gonna get caught?
This is an insect model 1385 automatic security and fire door. Voice controls, biometric scanning, and remote user access.
Remote user access.
I would have went with the 1355. No voice controls, but still a nice unit.
Who needs voice controls?
I think I can bypass this. Maybe not as easily as your apartment door, but easily enough.
Alright. Give it a shot. Nice.
We're in.
Oh, now the clock's ticking.
We should be able to use one of the terminals here, and I'll be able to crack the local security myself.
Good for you.
However, I need the password to get on the network and find where the source code lies.
Seriously?
According to anecdotal evidence on the mesh, humans do have difficulty remembering their passwords and often place reminders for themselves.
Very, very true.
Maybe there's a clue somewhere nearby.
So...
it's asking for the password.
Alright. We should look around
just
a little bit more.
Log out then.
Alright, log out. Let's take a look at name plaque. This desk belongs to one AP. I mean, yes, like it, but this one's theirs. Legs of the desk are welded to the floor. Sadly, there will be no high-pitched metal. I can't, like, shear the desk off the floor.
Please.
I can't talk to
the
desk.
It's tempting, but we really...
fine.
This could be our chance.
Network status screen.
There it is. Good eye.
What? That's... oh. Password, A23N whatever.
I thought that would have been harder.
Yeah, no, that was actually pretty pathetic. That thing. A23N8716H4. Alright, say it with me now.
And the password?
Enter password.
Go ahead and plug it in.
Really? Shit. A23H8754. I forget. Close enough.
Oops, did you forget?
Shit.
Just click log out.
Fine. Damn it! A23N8716H4. Alright, we're gonna try this again. N8716H4. Jeez. How's anybody supposed to remember all that? Even better if you just walk into the room and you reuse the password from the last time you played the game.
Go ahead and plug.
Just to impress Turing. Alright, so it's A23N87. 16H4. I don't know if that stands for anything, but sure.
That's it. We're in.
Yeah, we are.
Tomcat gave me an icebreaker program that will keep the VIs off of us while we search.
Sure, whatever.
I've had plenty of time to go over Hayden's data cache files, so I have a good idea of what I'm looking for. But we've probably attracted some attention already.
You think?
I'll go as fast as I can.
So I'm just supposed to sit here while he just goes.
Okay, I managed to get all the surface level data.
Alright.
Shoot!
Oh, we're caught.
The AI stopped me halfway in. We've been noticed, but not caught.
We're screwed.
Although I was able to get a decent chunk of my source code, there's still a lot of it that's behind some heavy security.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me.
The VIs want authentication with some sort of glyph.
Really?
Let me load it up. Key ID. I see. It wants us to combine 4 different glyphs to create a full image.
Okay.
I have to keep the icebreaker going so we don't get discovered. You'll have to handle this part.
Okay, sure.
Just study the prompt glyph that appears on the right side and click the correct squares to recreate it with all 4 parts.
Oh, I don't have to guess what the glyph is.
It looks like there's 5 locks we need to break through within 180 seconds.
3 minutes, 5 locks, not a problem.
This is our one chance to capture my full source code. This is make or break it.
All right. Don't fail me, Turing.
You. It's your time to shine.
Yep, no pressure.
Ready? I'm starting it. Here we go.
All right, here we go. One of these, a dot in the middle, circle, other circle? No, this one. 5 more successes required. Alright, so we need to make the square, the big circle, a little dot, and some kind of border thing. Shouldn't be so tricky.
Let's keep trying.
Alright, let's keep going. Circle. Oh, there's 3 circle sizes. Okay. That. What's the 4th shape here? The little circle. No, I messed it up again.
We're running out of time.
Yeah. We're running out of time. We're always running out of time. Just gotta keep a level head about this. Are you serious?
We're running out of
This can't be this difficult. Big circle. Little circle. Square border. I don't know what the last symbol is here. Okay, little circle, bigger circle, border, I'm not seeing the last symbol, though. What is it? Okay, we got one. 4 more to go. Circle, 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 big circle? That's not it. Okay. Diagonal, big circle, circles, circle.
We got this, let's go!
Alright, 3 to go. Big circle, squiggly thing, square? Other square? Nope. Oh, 3 more required. I hit a button I didn't mean to hit. Okay, this. Oh, that's no good. Sorry about that, Turing.
Think.
Sorry.
No, the VI is after me. The icebreaker isn't working anymore.
Well, I suck.
Cutting connection.
All right.
Ooh, it almost had me there, but at least I got some of. Let's get out of here before.
Yeah, we gotta run.
Stop what you're doing.
Oh.
Let's get out of here. Run.
All right. Well, that's one way to continue. So.
Oh, Dret, we couldn't get through in time.
Yeah. Oh well. We tried. We gave it our darndest, but no such luck.
We weren't able to recover my full source code. Only a partial amount.
Well.
That will make things harder for us, but we don't have another chance now.
Yeah, I tried. It's all Turing's fault for not being better with computers.
Let me call Tomcat and let them know we got some of my code.
It's probably good enough, though.
Hey, Turing, did you get everything?
Nope.
We weren't able to keep the counter-intrusion VI off of us long enough to get everything. I'm sending you what I have now.
Damn, that's not good. Okay, Okay, I think I can still work with this.
Yeah, Tomcat's pretty clever.
I'll have to reverse engineer some things from your personality profile, though, Turin. The new AIs might share some of your, quirks.
I'm not sure if that's good or bad.
It's gonna take me a little time, though, so you should spend the next few hours preparing to head into the Parallax Server Core on Treasure Island.
Oh. What do you mean prepare? I mean, okay, yeah.
That should be all done before nightfall.
Oh, so tonight's the night, then.
I don't relish the idea of going in on this alone.
Really?
Perhaps we could spend this time to gather together our allies. See if they're willing to take such a leap of faith with us.
Oh, you mean alone, just the two of us, not alone, just by yourself.
As fun as it would be watching you go full Yukino on them, Turin, I agree.
Oh, come on.
Maybe you could whip up some kind of distraction for the authorities to focus on? Buy you some time?
Oh, God. Lexi's gonna love this.
It's settled then. We'll go talk to Chad, Oliver, and Jess now.
I get the sense that I might not be the good guy in this game.
I'm sure we could have them all fake a human revolution protest turned riot. The police are watching those demonstrations like hawks. That should keep everyone busy enough and give us cover so we can do whatever we need to do.
My first instinct
is to ask Detective Rivers as well, but I do not want to force her into an untenable conflict of interest.
Right. Yeah, Detective Rivers isn't going to say yes to this, so there's no point in asking.
I'll run some more simulations to see if we should talk to anyone else.
Okay.
Sounds like you have it under control. Once you've gotten everyone together, head to the old storm drain entrance near the Parallax building.
Alright, let's...
I've been studying the plans between waiting for code to compile, and it looks like the best way past the exterior security measures is through there.
Okay.
You'd have to be a darn fool to try and wade through the water, but security is lighter than... It's light.
Yeah, you got a good point that for a robot, it's pretty comfortable with crime, though honestly, would you expect a robot to have any kind of qualms with crime?
I'm not sure I can play the fool, but I have a friend here for whom stubbornness is a job skill.
Oh, well, I have a feeling you're talking about.
When we're on site.
Yeah.
Good. Tomcat out.
Alright.
Message ahead to everyone and mark their current locations on your map.
Oh, good.
Start thinking about who our best allies have been and how we might convince them to help.
How about as pathetically as possible so we can go full Yukino on the final stage? Alright, so we got the punks here on Market Street. We got Jess over here. Let's go bug Jess. Also, can't just say this park theme. I was gonna say theme park, that's completely wrong. This park background track is just amazing. Alright. Sup, Jess?
Dear me.
Dear you.
We know.
Go ahead, then.
We're hoping to persuade your friends to help us.
You little shit! Know what? I don't have time for this!
Alright.
Hey, Bubblehead. You're not as chatty. Give me the whole situation in 3 sentences or less. Go.
Parallax is launching a new powerful machine intelligence onto the mesh.
Yep.
We want to stop it.
One more sentence.
We need you to pick a fight with the human revolution as a distraction so we can break into Parallax without getting arrested.
That's quite the compound sentence there.
And why exactly should I risk my people and career for this? Our entire movement. First, you want me to steal a car. Now incite riots?
Yep.
What kind of tech could be worth my people's lives?
It's really important tech, you know. If Parallax's AI goes Skynet, how will Congress react? That's a fair point. Put two and two together, Justice. People are getting scared of robots. Who will they get scared of next? Let's ask a Congress question.
You already know the general public doesn't really think of hybrids as human.
Yeah.
They'll lock down rights of all people they fear.
Mm-hmm.
Hybrids will become enemies of the state.
This is an argument we can't lose.
Shit.
Yep. So, ready to drop the cat-itude and help?
Oh, cut the bullshit. I can't stomach another moment of your insincerity. I will literally puke.
Alright.
So, hypothetically, what exactly would you have me do?
Let's see.
We need you to call in some help from your contacts and have them stir up trouble with the human revolution. We'll ensure our contacts inside the HR will be ready to escalate the protests, at least enough to draw an increased police presence.
Jeez.
That should buy us the breathing room we need. Nothing too wild, but enough to draw away their attention.
Yeah, I hope Turing's simulations are accurate, or that could get way out of control.
I figured it would be something like that. Yeah, okay. Let me make some calls.
Nice.
Let's get this straight, though. I'm doing this for me and my people.
Whatever.
I'm putting my reputation and career on the line here.
Yeah, you are.
You are asking me to start shit with the police.
Yes.
If you screw me on this, I will make you regret it.
Sweet.
I assure you, Ms. Mies, we will not screw you. Although, to be fair, I'm not entirely sure what that means.
Oh, Turing.
Right. I was tired of playing the public relations game with those human revolution assholes anyway.
Oh. Well, I guess there's that angle, too.
Time to crack some skulls.
Jeez.
Maybe not that much violence.
Turing. You don't understand violence.
Holy shit. Did you not get the understanding hyperbole chip or whatever?
Oh, that's true. That's also true.
I need to make some calls. Later.
Alright. Although, honestly, making calls is probably not the best way to do that. Good call on keeping her in the dark about the real plan. Wait. Have I completely, like, forgotten what the real plan is? Seriously?
You're right about that.
No, like, what is the real plan? I thought that was the plan.
I have a feeling she's going to be mighty ticked about having thousands of machine intelligences running around instead of just one.
Oh. Oh, that thing.
Does she really think I'm not too chatty? That aside, let's get going.
Yeah, let's go, go, go.
We shouldn't keep Chad and Oliver waiting any longer. They're likely to wander away if they get bored.
You know, I could just, like, go to the apartment and try to go to bed now. The game would be like, no, what are you doing? You can't do that. But it'd be funny if the game just let you do that.
What is going on?
Oh, what are you talking about?
Detective Rivers, who we weren't expecting.
Yeah, I bet you weren't. Just cut the crap, please.
Really?
Do you even realize how big of a hornet's nest you kicked when you knocked over that data center?
That was good.
I'm assuming that was you, yeah? My superior came and yanked me away from all my work on Hayden as soon as we got the call.
What? What are you talking about? Oh, right. Days have passed, so you're able to start your case on Hayden.
Told me it was politically unwise to keep digging.
Jeez.
That's bullshit doublespeak, meaning ass covering for the corporate overlords.
True.
So now I'm officially grounded, and I know there's something you're not telling me. Don't try to hide it. I probably could have been more useful all along if you'd loop me in.
Yeah. I doubt that.
I will shove my foot so far up your ass, you'll have to lace up your own teeth.
Sweet. I mean, oh, that sounds painful.
We're sorry for keeping you in the dark. We found out that Hayden has been killed by someone inside Parallax, and we are now on the move to stop them from doing worse.
Yeah, no, I told you, Turing, we should have just looped in the police at the very beginning. We shouldn't be doing any of this on our own. But whatever.
Wait, what? I was hoping you were about to tell me that all this was just some ruse to win yourself a Pulitzer.
Really? This is about avenging his death.
You said this was about finding the truth.
I lied. It's about vengeance.
And I'm betting that raiding the data center was only step one in your two-step plan to really get in trouble, yeah?
Oh, you know
it. All right,
it.
Then. I'm in.
Sweet. That's more like it.
Someone has to keep you from getting yourself killed.
Oh. Yeah.
Your sister would never forgive me, and we just started talking again. Besides, I'm occasionally fond of you as well.
Yeah, that's cool that you two are talking.
So, screw the badge. I'm tired of being a corporate pawn shoved around by whomever has the deepest pockets.
Wow. It's great how, like, we talked with Jess. Jess is willing to put her career on the line. You're putting your career on the line. All this is happening because some robot comes to me in my sleep and tells me this weird story. Plot twist, Hayden's not real.
I got into this job to help people, and I've done too damn little of that lately.
Okay. Well, it's not my fault you sucked with the Froyo stand thing.
I am in.
Okay.
Just like that?
That was easy.
Just like that. What's the plan?
There's no plan.
Parallax got rid of Hayden because he was about to publish his research on me. They're about to launch the first independent machine intelligence as a data collection agent on the mesh.
Yep.
They're worried that Congress will shut them down if they find out how powerful it is.
I'm guessing we're a little more worried that they won't. That's some Big Brother stuff right there.
Precisely. With the data we stole, we should be able to shut down the program from inside Parallax's main server center.
With Tomcat's help, of course.
It's messier than that, but that's the gist of it. That's our next target.
I'm not sure where I can help, exactly. Maybe keep some heat off of you while you do whatever it is.
You know, you said your goal is to try to keep us from getting killed. Now, if you're saying you don't know where that you fit into this plan, it sounds like we're gonna die. Just saying.
I'm certain your assistance will prove invaluable.
Great. Machine is telling us what to do.
Okay. Message me when and where to meet up. Oh, by the way, call your sister. She misses you.
We don't get along, sorry.
Yeah, well, tough shit. Call her.
Not gonna happen.
That's enough talking. I'm heading back to the station to keep an eye on things. See you when it's time. And sorry about your friend Hayden. We're gonna finish this.
Alright.
Bye, Detective Rivers!
Wow, we're still calling her Detective Rivers. Great.
One more ally on our side.
But yeah, where are Chad and Oliver? Where'd they go? Oh, here they are. Sup, guys?
How's it sinking?
How's it sinking, indeed.
Yes, how are you?
Sinking like a ship.
Busy. We were hoping we could enlist your aid again.
Y'all need some more fake IDs or something? Or maybe some third-hand VR dramas?
No, we just need you to start some criminal activity.
Third-hand?
Yeah, like, you know, guy I know found them when they fell off the back of a truck.
Great.
I thought VR dramas were distributed primarily over the mesh.
depends if you create your own drama.
Ignore him. I made the mistake of convincing him to watch some turn-of-the-century mobster movies with me. I regretted it instantly.
And yet you still kept going.
I really like that one with the dude from Montana in it.
Dude from Montana?
Whatever. So what'd you jerks need? Since apparently my VR dramas ain't good enough.
Well, you said you were good at violence, so...
Well, we're going to be engaging in some more activity of dubious legality.
Lexi's got us covered. We'll be fine.
We were wondering if you wouldn't mind helping create a distraction to keep the police out of the way.
You know, since we sent you to the police before, just for mere graffiti, we were wondering if we could get you in some greater trouble.
Y'all gonna go hit those parallax bastards that did your dad in?
Yes, actually, that was surprisingly accurate.
Yeah. Turns out that Chad's not entirely dumb.
He's smarter than he pretends to be.
That's really not saying much, because he pretends to be awfully dumb.
Do you have a plan in mind already?
No, not really. We're just gonna hit the data center. Oh, I mean, we're planning for you guys. We just need Chad there to do what comes naturally.
I am a man of many talents.
Name two.
Swearing and graffiti.
I'm super good at claw machines, and I can fit an entire hot dog in my mouth at once, with bun.
I needed to know that.
I'm sorry I asked.
We just need you to gather a bunch of, like-minded individuals. Bring them to Market and Powell. We want you to start a fake riot with all the other folks we gather, so the police will mobilize there.
See, it's also important that we coordinate the time of this riot, you know?
A group of hybrids will be waiting to fight back.
As much as we'd like to.
We'll do it!
There we go.
No, we won't.
Yeah, we will.
What?
What? Really?
Chad, I go along with a lot of the harebrained schemes you cook up, but not this time.
Harebrained, like the rabbit.
We barely managed to get out of the last hole we dug. You promised me we're done with the human revolution.
Yeah, plus, you know, this is actual violence and things can get really ugly.
But Ollie!
No, no buts.
So, wow, actually Chad seems to value Oliver's opinion. So yeah, it seems like Oliver gets to pull the strings here.
I'm sorry. I know you need help, but we cannot stick our necks out on this one.
Huh. It's almost like the decisions I made earlier in the game are having some kind of consequence here. Nah, it's just my imagination.
Yeah, okay. You're right, Ollie. Sorry, Turing. Your friend's a jerk. But you two are good at looking out for yourselves, right?
Heh, sure, why not?
You can pull through. Right?
Really, Chad? Really? After... See, now if I actually persuade Chad that we need him... I just can't do that, can I?
I would never want you to put yourselves at undue risk. We'll figure this out.
Okay. So the game's not gonna give me an option to, like, be a total dick.
Thank you, Starfucker.
Hey, you called me it!
Yeah, cool. We did. It's a good pronoun.
Anyway, we've got a jet. Don't be a stranger, Bobblehead. You've got my contact.
I guess we will indeed. Smell you later.
Wow. That's the coolest thing he said. Now, the problem is, like, his glasses still aren't on, so he doesn't look cool at all. But at least he said the thing. Well, that didn't go as we'd hoped. Yeah, my personality may lead to things getting done, but it hardly engenders much loyalty. Perhaps you should remember that honey catches more flies than vinegar. No, Turing. Turing, you don't understand. This is a game. We are pursuing the ending that's most interesting. We'll muddle through like we always do, no matter how... Oh, Turing is so odd to me. He knows. He knows I'm trying to stuff my foot down my own throat. There's one more person he thinks we should talk to. And that person would... Oh, right. Dr. Fairlight. Can you give us vital information on how to access the server complex? He's just a board member, but... yeah, he's probably been keeping a key eye on Parallax for quite some time. Lexi and Jess may be able to buy us cover, but Fairlight could help us get our way in. I'm not sure that I trust him. I don't either, but I'm not sure we have any other choice. Out of everyone that's assisted us this far, I trust him the least. He has an unclear, ulterior motive. I'm only guessing it lines up with our own. It's a risk, talking to him. But a calculated risk. We should at least sound him out if possible. We might be able to get a read if he's telling the truth or not. Should still be at the hospital. Okay, fine. Turing's not gonna let me just do whatever I want, so I guess hospital bound we go. Yeah, I've been totally recovering just fine. Sup, Decker? How's it going?
Oh, hey. Funny seeing you two here.
Yeah, we are pretty funny.
What can I help with today?
Actually, I don't know.
There have been developments that we need to let Dr. Fairlight know about. Could you show us to him?
Oh, yeah, Dr. Fairlight, I pushed him out the window.
No can do, I'm afraid.
Oh.
Fairlight is speaking at this really important holiday benefit, and he'll have my ass for dinner if I interrupt him for anything. And I mean anything.
Wow.
So, is this something I might help with? Fairlight has kept me fairly up to speed on your situation.
I don't know if I believe that. We'll pass. It's pretty confidential.
Look, most of the old man's work is confidential. You think I just do his laundry?
Honestly, given your ridiculous outfit, yes.
This high up in the tech sector, secrets can earn you millions. But hey, if you don't trust me, that's your loss.
We don't have time for this!
Oh, okay, Turing's gonna take this from me. We should tell Fairlight directly.
Well, you could wait for the event to finish, but those usually go until well past midnight. I'm honestly surprised the old man can manage them these days.
He's not gonna take any break through the entire event? Okay. You know, it seems like this would have been a detail we could have planned out, well, I guess time's of the essence, but... You know, figuring this detail out might have been an important thing to do first, before staging the riot.
We don't have that kind of time.
Then...
Yeah, Turing, way to go. Okay, we'll tell you.
I'm happy to listen.
Because we don't have any time.
We recently discovered that Hayden might have been removed because he was about to interfere with a secret project Parallax is launching.
Oh, yeah, that secret project.
They've developed a networked machine intelligence that they're about to release onto the mesh.
It's a good thing we're in the hospital with witnesses nearby. Even if those witnesses are robot. Well, that's actually a problem. But whatever.
We were hoping that Dr. Fairlight could get us a way in so that we can shut it down.
You know, that little vacuum robot on the floor is probably a spy. It's recording our conversation, listening to our every move. It's going to report us. That little vacuum robot that beeps so cheerfully every time we pat it on the head. That's going to be the link that takes us down. I'm calling it now.
I cannot overstate the danger of Parallax having control of this entity.
Yep, that cheerful little bot that just whirs back and forth is going to be our ultimate demise.
Phew, you weren't kidding, were you?
No.
The comment from that kind of thing would be a scummy marketer's wet dream.
Comment?
Not to mention all the possible applications to the CIA.
Huh. Comment? Common interest, perhaps? I'm not sure.
So, now will you call Dr. Fairlight?
Actually, it goes a bit above and beyond that. I don't think I can tell Yannick about this.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me.
What? Why not?
Look, you know, and I know, that the old man's itching to get back at the helm of Parallax.
Sure, of course.
He plays a good game of ceremonial ribbon cutting, but he's been sniffing around for a way to get back at the board ever since he was outed.
Yeah. Yeah, no. So, obviously, there's huge danger in telling
Thankfully,
him about this.
This could play right into his hands, but he's gotta have plausible deniability.
So he's gotta trust us as he does something to distract
us. There's even a whiff that he orchestrated this. He'll be done for. It's a win-win for all of us, right?
So, yeah, the fact that he's distracting the board, engaging them in all kinds of whatever it takes to put him back at the helm. You know, that works for us. He's gonna work on our behalf, voluntarily, without knowing anything about what we know.
This is all very clandestine. What do you suggest?
Yannick pays me so that when shit hits the fan, I can take care of it without him even hearing about it.
Makes sense.
Usually it's errands, but stuff like this also falls in the job description.
Seriously? What was the last time something like this happened?
My military training should be more than enough to get us into the server mainframe without inside info.
Oh. Military training. That's pretty spooky.
And once we're in, we can just clean this mess right up.
I forgot.
While making another one.
Right. I still don't trust you, Decker.
Well, that's just PG. Alright, storm the castle without me.
Wait. Is he serious?
You clearly already know how to safely scope a battlefield. How to avoid detection by enemies. How and when to escalate to combat.
You know it, Decker. You know it.
You know, and everything else.
Military training.
But just in case there's something you don't know, it might be smart to bring me along. Look. I did this for a living. I'm an expert. A professional.
I did this for 2 weeks before I got sent here.
But you're too green to be that confident about going in alone.
He's gonna try to talk some sense into me.
You've made your point, Mr. Decker.
Even Turing's pissed. It's up to you, Turing.
Right. We'll accept your help, Mr. Decker.
There we go.
Great. I knew you'd come around.
Yeah, that was challenging.
We do this right and make that launch crash tomorrow, and Yannick will be able to buy out enough shares to get a seat back on the board.
Oh, Right, because he's divested already, so yeah.
You can meet us at the entrance to the storm drains just south of the main parallax complex. We'll make our entry from there.
Although, honestly, if we fail to clean up our initial steps, it's gonna go south.
I can work with that. Just give me a bit to pick up my gear. Don't you worry. This'll all be over soon.
It's all going according to plan.
Well, that's the last of the people I think we can recruit. Let's head to Parallax now. I'll message Detective Rivers, and we can wait for Mr. Decker to catch up to us there.
Sounds like a plan.
Comcast should be done with their programming soon, and then we can head in.
All right.
Is that everything? I hope so. We get one shot here.
Yeah, like the one shot we had to get your entire source code, and I messed
ready?
It up. Nope, not ready. But we have to do it anyway. This game does not autosave, so please be sure to save frequently. Alright, here we go. Chapter 6? Oh. Wow, that's dark. I'm being informed that I should save.
Detective Rivers, I see you've beaten us here.
Yeah. Also, you made it here before we did. Oh, you mean that kind of beaten. Alright.
Wanted to get the lay of the land before anybody else showed up. When are we ready to head in?
Let me save first.
We're waiting for one other person, and then I need to get our distraction going.
Speak of the devil.
Wow, you two get along.
Mr. Decker, precisely. Detective Rivers, allow me to introduce you to...
I know who he is. Leon Decker, ex-Marine, served in North Korea. Record heavily redacted.
Heavily redacted.
And working for Yannick Fairlight, who I'm sure is willing to help us out of the kindness of his heart, yeah?
Oh, of course.
You
his
have
wallet.
Me at a disadvantage, miss.
Really?
Though, let's drop the pretenses, I've never made a secret of Yannick's goals here.
That's true.
He needs Parallax melted down a little for him to get his chair back, and they need to stop some dangerous software.
It's all about a chair.
Ha! And I'm sure that's all your cards laid out on the table, huh?
You know it.
We're all on the same side. Simple as that.
Really? Wow, you two... That doesn't seem like the most upfront negotiation.
You sure you want to work with this guy, Turing? I don't like the look of him.
See? Like, yeah, Turing wouldn't let me drop Liam, so we're stuck with him.
You've got good eyes, Detective.
They're new.
Ha!
Yes, Detective Rivers. I believe Mr. Decker will prove invaluable on this mission.
I don't.
Statistically, we're an entire 17% more likely to succeed with his expertise.
Really? You figured that out all by yourself?
Fine. We'll play it your way.
Great. What's the plan, little guy?
Yeah, we don't have a plan.
Tomcat and I have been unable to find the precise schematics of these storm drains, as they underwent some modifications when Parallax began construction here. But the city's primary power and communication lines still run parallel along them, for maintenance purposes.
Oh. Really? Okay. I guess that makes some sense, but... surprising that they would make things so predictable. Push
the
him down the
center
shaft.
Is certain to be set adjacent to the tunnel complex to allow easier connection.
I don't believe you, Turing.
If we make our way through the drains, we should be able to exit at least close to the new server building. that will get us past the worst of the exterior alarms and defenses of the complex.
How fantastic would it be if the tunnels were heavily armed and all these cameras and perhaps even weapons in the tunnels, and just the front door were like wide open and unprotected? How fascinating would that be?
They don't have security alarms in the storm drains?
Exactly.
Well, they probably do, but it's unlikely they're in good repair.
Oh my goodness. We're risking all this over Turing thinking that things are unlikely. Yeah, it's funny. We're 6 chapters into the game, and Turing's still pushing everyone around. And I don't think it's aware of just the degree to which it's manipulating everything. Turing is Skynet. It's the virus that's going to ruin everything.
The water level rises frequently, and maintenance is usually only handled during the dry season in the middle of summer.
Yep. So lesson learned, Parallax. Pay your IT service people.
The moving water should give an enormous amount of false positives. We'll have to move quickly, since the rains upstream will cause erratic surges in the water levels.
Would you say we would have to move swift as the coursing river? With all the force of a great typhoon?
What about this server building? Do we have plans for it? Any info on the guard rotations?
Not a clue.
Construction on that finished only last year. It's state-of-the-art and currently services the primary ROM control and distribution network.
Ugh. That's weird. Why would your data center... Or I don't know.
Based on what we've learned, I'm assuming it was built primarily to give Big Blue enough power to sift through all of the data on the network.
Why are all the data things all in one spot? It seems like if you had a data center, you wouldn't want it to be in the middle of a downtown area. And even if it were in the middle of a downtown area, you wouldn't want to connect it to these drains. You really wouldn't want it to be habitable at all. You'd want it to be as well isolated as possible. If anything, you want it separated as far as possible from the storm drains. And maybe elevated a bit. I mean, yeah, there will be some kind of storm drain in the complex itself, but... You don't want there being any risk of water getting into the data center. So, whatever.
That's the AI, right?
Right. The entire facility is automated. Security, maintenance, even new construction, all run by ROMs.
Cool.
There might be a single human engineer on site to take care of anything the ROMs can't figure out, but we shouldn't have to worry about any intervention.
You say that. You remember we just barely managed to get our way into the other complex. That other data center. To obtain some source code. And we had to shoot the person, the receptionist. Now, if we're talking about an engineer, that engineer's gotta be... He's gotta have some security training. If he's gonna by himself secure that entire complex, or I don't know.
At least, not immediately.
There should at least be a security guard somewhere.
I think we can handle some robots, assuming Leon is as good of a shot as the blank marks in his file suggest.
Oh. Well said.
Let's hope we don't have to find out, ma'am.
Once we make our way to the primary server control core, I can link myself into the network and Tomcat can work their magic. That's all we have to do.
Now, I assume Turing is going to communicate via satellite with Tomcat, but we're going into these storm drains which are underground. I don't think there's going to be communication. I think there's going to be communication problems.
That's an awful lot of question marks before the prophet. But we'll figure it out.
You have a lot of faith in me.
Any anything you'd like to add?
I still want to save the game. How are we getting out?
I'll buy us some time, one way or another. At the very least, we should be able to bluff our way out with my badge.
Oh. That's right. Maybe the storm drains are intended as a massive taxpayer-funded cooling system for the AI when it becomes online. Sure, we'll go with that.
There'll be hell to pay later, but we'll make it out with our hides intact.
Alright. Yeah, I guess... Yeah, having this cooperation from the police is a good thing. Lexi's gonna lose her job over this.
You can just pretend I'm the bad guy and slap some cuffs on me. Yannick can get me out of holding if I need it.
A sound plan, Mr. Decker.
Yeah, I won't have to pretend much for that.
Yeah, that's true. We don't have a backup plan. We don't need a backup plan. Let's do this.
Okay, let me call Jess and get our distraction going.
Seriously, I cannot access the save menu. Whatever. Don't need
Hello,
a save.
Jess.
We'll get this right first try. There won't be any complications.
Holy shit. Did the robot really just call me? How did you even get my personal line?
Wouldn't you like to know?
You know what? Never mind. One more thing to have my tech guy handle. After these CTV cameras all mysteriously lose connection to the mesh.
Jess, we're calling to...
I know why you're calling.
Yeah. You sure about that?
Sorry, I really can't talk right now. I'm in the middle of inciting a riot and putting my friends in danger.
So... You sure you can't talk?
Let's get this going, people! Go show those revolution scum who the real future of humanity is!
I'm sure Brian Mulberry's gonna really appreciate
that. Good to hear you have things in hand.
Oh yeah, all under control. Pass on my love. In case I didn't say it before, I believe in you.
Alright, let's go back home. Call it a day. We've done whatever good we're intending to do.
Prick.
Ah, well said. Well said.
Right.
Yeah, Turing's having a good time.
We're good to go. Let's hurry.
Oh, okay, if you say so. But first, we gotta save. Because the game tells us to save frequently. Sure. Whatever. A4. The paper. Because I'm feeling not too creative at the moment. Alright. Back we go. So, how do we get in trouble out here? Just... lamp. Oh, I can't zap the lamp. Yeah. What's this plant? No, nobody's hidden the bush. No, I want to know what the bush is. This is very important. Alright, can I know what the... Oh, it's a palm tree, of course. Large palm tree looms overbearingly beside the path. But what's this in the... Oh, the HQ. Lid. Shrub. Alright. Let's go storm the HQ, guys. That's the headquarters. Yes, all that's just for one corporation. Oh, that's why. It's not a city. That's okay. It's also just the headquarters. Never mind the at least 500 offices worldwide. This is a street light. It's not just a lamp, it's a street lamp. Wait, can I shoot the street lamp? Oh, I don't have my phaser anymore. This could be a nice place to hang your umbrella. But the umbrella might come in handy again. Okay, fine, fine. Let's look at the tunnel entrance. It's a real safe house bunker vibe to it. Like there's a lifetime's worth of dried fruit and canned goods sitting beneath it just in case. Shoot the bird. Yeah, I can't select the bird, unfortunately. Nor do I have my phaser. Or stunner. I thought I... Here we go, walkway. Short walking path that diverts from the street and runs all the way down to the tunnel entrance. You reach down and pluck one weed from the cement cracks. What an activist. Everyone has to do their part, and you've done yours, so you refuse to contribute further. Okay, fine.
We can't go in with the tunnel lid blocking us.
Oh. Okay, I suppose... Let's use the brochure for the human revolution on the lid. No combination of the words destroy, all, and implants make up a password that opens up the tunnel. Fine. Let's use the Parallax badge. Swipe the badge to secure. Oh! Wow. Okay. Nice. We're in. I didn't think we'd have to authenticate with that.
Okay, it's time.
Yep.
Sure
is.
We'll call Tomcat once we get inside, assuming we find a way in, and they'll lead us into the system.
Can't Tomcat just call us and give you the source code, like, now?
Let's go.
I mean, is she still seriously working on that? Huh. It's better lit in here than I expected.
The city replaced all the lighting in areas like this with low power, high durability LEDs a few years ago. Actually cut down on vagrants setting up camp in the tunnels, drowning when the rains came through.
Oh. Really? How so? You just see better enough to know when to clear out. Maybe. City's so crazy. Yeah, I don't know. We should move quickly. We should always. Oh. Yeah, Turing doesn't float well. Nor can it swim. Alright, so we'll look around for a map. Might be printed on the wall, or a terminal if someone was willing to waste that much money. There's not gonna be terminals down here. You said there's water everywhere. So fine, we move forward. We continue moving forward. Just keep going. Look! There's an information terminal. Now we know what the city spends its credits on. Let's see where we are. Plan out our path then. Well, fine. Alright, so we have to go right 3, down 1, left 1, down 1, right 2, left, and then... Wow, that's a really complicated maze. Basically, just follow the wall. Go straight, follow the right edge, and... Oh, I guess we're not going to be able to see the walls as we're progressing through here. Let's see, right, forward 3, right, forward 1... Board one, left. Just like right and a left and a right and a left, and you know. Actually, a right. We take this straight. Keep going straight. Take a left. Keep going straight and take another left. And that's that. Pretty simple. I actually expected this to be a lot harder. Oh. Caution sign. It's orange, so it just means caution, not warning. So yeah, we need to go right. I thought this would be considered going straight, but whatever. Be careful, everyone. The water is starting to deepen. We need to get going. If the water rises too much more, we're gonna get washed out. So this is where we gotta go left. And just keep following the path. And when we have our next opportunity to go left again. And just keep going. Oh, this is no good. Stop jabbering. Keep your stunners above the water. Fair enough. We'll just keep going. Keep going. Warning, don't drown. Okay, good to know. Yeah, drowning would be a bad thing, I suppose. Turn back. Yeah, we're gonna drown if we turn back. So, what were you guys talking about? The bird flying back and forth is bugging you. C4. West Coast, yeah. So it happens in Columbia cities. Also, oh. Yeah. Yeah, I would be careful. I don't know. Remind me to pass on this part of the mission next time. I'd rather deal with your sister being mad at- oh. Who's gonna notice us? Seriously?
I think I know where we are.
I think you know where we are.
Parallax filed this building's plans with the city per regulation, and although they're clearly incomplete, these hallways have been mapped out rather well.
Oh, we got another maze? Seriously?
It's a straight shot to the server core from here, more or less.
Oh, just go straight then. Easy
peasy. Got activity. Looks like something's moving up ahead.
Shoot.
The building security VI must have noticed us.
Really? Really, you think so, Turing?
We'll have to make it past those ROMs without getting ourselves caught.
No problem. We've all got stunners and we'll make those bots fry.
Yeah, I get the sense that Turing's about to tell us something.
Well, is there another way? We don't have to destroy them completely, do we?
Are you serious, Turing?
Not to put too fine a point on it, Turing, but they're not like you. They're just plastic and programming. Puppets.
Turing.
But they won't always be. Not for much longer.
Turing. Oh my goodness.
Lexi, Decker, the truth is, we're planning to replace Big Blue with my original source code.
It's great that we tell them this now.
Once we do that, we'll have the power to make every ROM a sapient individual. Just like me.
Sounds like an excellent plan.
We aren't shutting down Big Blue. We're changing it.
And then putting it online immediately.
I know it seems like splitting hairs, but it seems wrong to destroy them when we've come here to give them life. They deserve it.
Oh, dear.
Oh, fine. Here. Give me that stunner. All right. Done. I've changed the settings on it to give a lower yield with a more lengthy pulse.
Fine.
It should disrupt them long enough for us to get past and won't do any permanent damage to any systems that can't be repaired.
I mean, they're just plastic and bolts. You could replace them fairly easily anyway.
Does that assuage your bleeding heart?
Whoa, Decker, you have to be so cool about
it. Yes, thank you, Mr. Decker.
Really? Okay, fine.
No problem. We can't all be soldiers.
Decker and I will keep our stunners at default settings so we can handle any humans that might show up.
Okay. Wait, so I'm gonna have to be shooting these.
That low powered pulse would just piss most people off, but wouldn't stop them. You'll have to take care of the shooting for now.
Wow. That's gonna suck.
Lead the way. We're almost there.
Alright.
Oh, look. And that's a Malcolm Jr. model.
Aw, how cute.
They perform basic maintenance duties mostly. They're cute, too.
Of course they are. I mean, that's why they're... That's why you see these robots everywhere, is because they're cute.
Wait a second.
shooting at us!
Oh! Oh-ho! See, Turing, this is why, well, yeah.
Take it down!
Alright. Let's go, go, go! That's pretty funny. Oh, but Turing.
We've got more of them!
Wait. I should have been playing the Mega Phobotaur arcade thing a lot more than I played it. Oh man. This is gonna be a Mega Phobotaur all over again.
That's a full-scale Malcolm!
Okay. It's a bigger target. Such a big target.
We can't let them stop us. We've come too far. Let's finish this.
Jeez.
That's the last of them.
Oh, good. Wait, I don't believe you.
The door to the server core should be just past this maintenance tunnel.
I don't believe you, Turing.
There probably won't be any more security once we get there. Too much risk
probably.
Of damaging the equipment that supports the racks.
Oh, okay, that's a fair point, but we're gonna run into a Oh.
Hey,
I wonder who we're gonna run into.
At this point, I think Lexi and I should hang back and guard the entrance, in case more security shows up.
Suck, Decker.
The alarm has been tripped, so backup is bound to arrive sooner rather than later.
Yep.
Good idea. Neither of us know any of the technical stuff. We can hold our own against Christmas Eve level security.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, we'd be useless down there.
Plus, you don't know anything about computers.
That works. We'll move as fast as we can, then.
Yeah, let's just stand here discussing our strategy.
Be careful, you two.
All right.
Good luck up ahead. We'll catch up soon.
Come on, let's go.
Here we go. We're gonna run into something or someone. It's not gonna be simple.
This should be the last hurdle before reaching Big Blue.
Oh, this should be the last hurdle.
The configuration ahead doesn't match the available floor plans for this section of the building.
You don't say.
The path is blocked off. We can't go any further in this direction.
Decker needs an opportunity to contact the crowd.
Hold on for a moment. I'm going to tap into the maintenance mesh and see if I can find a way to open up this path.
I mean, if you can't find a way, then we're kind of screwed, so... Can't I just blast it open?
We should be able to move around freely enough using this.
Alright, what is this?
Do you mind opening the door in front of us?
Oh, I mind. You'll have to open it. Wait, what?
Good work. Let's head in.
That was weird. That's supposed to be some sort of puzzle.
None of this is detailed in the public floor plans for the building. The mainframe seems to have been moved up a floor.
Why would you... Well, I guess if you're concerned about flooding, but...
Perhaps they installed extra heat exchangers in preparation for Big Blue going online. Oh, a call from...
Oh, shit. That sucks. Yeah, that's bad.
Oh no, I've lost Lexi's transmission.
Yep, oh well.
She sounded so distressed. What could have happened?
You know, let's just keep going forward, you know?
I can't reach her!
Oh no.
All of this equipment's interference, combined with being underground, is deflecting most of the transmissions I would otherwise have the ability to receive.
You know, This is why I said you probably should have downloaded that source code from Tomcat earlier. We gotta go finish the mission.
I agree. Lexi is a skilled combatant, and if we go back now, we'd be putting ourselves and the entire mission in jeopardy.
Well, yeah.
However, we won't be able to contact Tomcat or the others until we reach the main control room.
I don't know how you expect that we're gonna... Oh. Maybe the control room has meshnet access.
We'll just need to call her as soon as we can. But perhaps we should consider hiding first. If security got to her and Decker, they could be headed here next.
Are you serious, Turing?
If someone comes, we can hide amongst the heat exchangers until they pass.
Okay, we got a game of cat and mouse going
on. We'll just take a moment to assess the situation. The noise and mist from the climate control should mask our presence.
Oh, that's useful.
I'll switch to quiet mode on my interface for the duration.
Good for you. Okay, lead the way.
This way. Someone's coming. Hide!
Alright.
Hello?
Wait. That sounds... That can't possibly be who I think it is.
Turing? Are you there? I need help.
Yeah, you're playing with us.
No? Hello?
You're so playing with us.
Come out. Come out. Wherever you are.
Yeah, I thought so. So... That's excellent. Wow. Alright, I admit, like when I said, I was surprised, like, just by every plot twist in this game. This is actually a really predictable plot twist when you think about it, but no, I was thinking that he was, like, trying to use, no, that didn't remotely sound like Fairlight, but... I'm not sure who I mistook that for.
Surprise!
Yeah, so he turned down our stunner, so we're screwed.
And here I was thinking I would get the drop on the two of you. And we could do this the easy way. well, at least I tried.
Yeah, see, this is why we should have left this all to the police to begin with. Honestly, I don't know if it matters whether it's a cyborg or zombie or whatever.
I guess that cop warned you I was coming.
Yes.
She's got a hell of a set of papers on her, huh? Must have cost a pretty penny to let her see through my combat cloak.
What? That's impressive. She's got combat cloaking, but she's... Oh! She just said she got new eyes installed.
And now, she's gone and hid, and I can't seem to find her to finish her off.
Well, oh, shit.
I'll just have to rip the augments out of her on my way out. They'll make a nice souvenir.
Yeah, I don't like where this game is going.
I'm honestly surprised my gears still grind, with how old some of my parts are. I could use it.
So... Huh. It would have been interesting if we could have pursued this chapter without Leon.
Decker is a combat android?
Really? You're slow.
And then you decide to change our little plan here tonight. And now I have to clean up your mess before you make a bigger one.
Seriously? What's this, Decker? What did you want?
I won't lie. I'm going to enjoy every minute of this.
Wow.
I'm not usually one for grand speeches. A combat android can only fill out paperwork for so many years before you begin to get thirsty.
Decker. You know, there's plenty of places you can go. You can go, like, to the arcade and just take it out on the machine, you know. There's no need to go killing people. Just saying.
Theatrics are fun, but I like to get straight to the bloodshed. You know?
I don't know, man. Decker, I don't think it's necessary to, well... Actually, wait. If he's a combat android, and... Or it's a combat android or whatever, and claims to be, sapient, then aren't we competing against a sapient AI already? And it seems way more advanced than a ROM.
So let's do this the hard way.
Yeah, so we're gonna have to run like hell.
The hard way. I love the hard way. Lucky for you, your cop friend fried my cloaking emitter with her stunner before she ran off. But really,
oh.
That's better.
Are you serious?
See, now you have hope, you can win. I can't wait to watch it drain from your eyes as I wear your entrails like a scarf.
Okay, sure. So I guess, let me guess, this is another maze puzzle. Oh shit. Oh dear.
So here's how this is going to work. On my turn, I'm going to tell you a story.
Oh, thank goodness this is turn-based.
I'm going to tell you every minuscule detail about how I've stalked you this entire time and have been ahead of you every step of the way.
Okay.
On your turn, you're going to run, maybe hide, perhaps a little of both.
Okay.
Doesn't matter. Player's choice. Lucky you.
I'm not sure I understand
this
game.
Keep in mind, if I manage to scare you or piss you off really bad, I might be able to hear you breathing deeper.
Yeah, I have a sense that that's gonna happen.
Your heartbeat is like sonar to me. The louder it pounds, the faster I race to stop it.
Sweet. This sucks.
I might even be able to smell you if the currents in the air are just right.
Ay, ay, ay.
So that's the game. Won't this be fun?
Oh. You remind me of a Bolton character. I'm just saying.
This is bad. What do? We can't fight him! Wait, we have the... No... He messed with our zapper.
We can't take him
with these settings, and there's no time for me to figure out how to revert it.
Yep.
We also don't have much firepower left. We only have the charge left for 4 stun level shots, at most.
Oh. Well, that's no good.
It'll have to be enough.
Well,
Let me see. The interface I'm using allows me to control whether these surrounding server columns are active or not.
Yeah, no, attacking him will prove futile, because he's got a lethal weapon, and we don't.
If I close off some nodes, it should at least slow his movement and disorient him. It won't stop him outright, but... I can focus on tracking Decker's location using this, and you just tell me where to block off his path so we can try to navigate him away from us.
Alright.
Don't try to trap him, he might get more angry. Just have him to avoid us until we think up some sort of solution.
Yeah.
If he finds us, be ready to shoot.
I don't like this game at all.
Ready or not, here I come.
At least it's turn-based, so I...
You take the lead.
There's some possibility that I might not fail.
Get by the clothes first, then let's get moving.
Alright. Noted. And then... where to close first? Oh shit. Probably shouldn't have done that. We are so screwed. Screwed.
Run before he recovers.
Okay. Running, running, running.
That bought us some time, but only a bit. Keep moving.
All right. So we close that door. Close the right door. Just run like heck.
So let's see. Where do I start?
Cut a cooling line, flood the floor, cut the largest power line, then charge it. Yeah, that's an option. That would probably kill everybody.
I suppose the old man is a good enough place as any. He honestly thinks he's some kind of modern Machiavelli. But to be frank, he hasn't been on much of a winning streak lately.
Really? You don't say.
Parallax used him as a scapegoat for that big ROM database hack back in 54.
Of course.
They even got him to resign as CTO just to powder their own noses.
Yep.
And as soon as he did, they stabbed him in the back and voted him off the board the very next day. Even I'll admit, that's cold.
Eh, whatever.
Since then, he's been licking his wounds, waiting for the chance to get revenge, to get back where he feels he belongs.
I mean, revenge is a pretty strong word for that.
I dug through dirt for years with him, looking for a way to blackmail Parallax so that he could make his way back into the Elite. So imagine our surprise when one of our informants inside Parallax tells us of this brand new Big Blue project. The perfect opportunity. But we had to act immediately.
Oh, of course.
And then you walk in right through the front door of Hayden, the only person with the ability to take advantage of Big Blue, who's just mysteriously gone missing.
You don't say.
I was going to dump your body in the bay, but Fairlight figured it might pay off if we give you a little lead, and waited to see what you could track down. Find us another way.
Really?
And boy, did it ever.
Okay, let's move.
All right. So I have to seal a thing. I'm honestly unsure what the hell this thing is here. So, I don't know. Let's seal this thing here. And I don't know. Maybe the right door. And let's go left.
I suppose I should tell you how impressive Hayden's little creation is. Oh, except he's dead, so I guess it doesn't matter.
Yeah, okay, that's fine.
But without you, we wouldn't have our path to Big Blue, the gold mine. Of course, Fairlight would prefer to not tank Parallax stock to the shitter. But this is too good of an opportunity to pass up.
Oh, of course. Actually, he probably doesn't care about the stock too much because he's not on board.
As soon as I'm done playing with you two, I'm going to trash this entire server complex. That'll wreck tomorrow's launch, but only temporarily.
Oh, of course.
Let's move!
So... again, I'm unsure what the exclamation point's all about. I have to seal two doors. This seems to be the rule. And the game tells me not to piss off the dude, so I don't know. Oh, I'm confused. Suppose it wouldn't hurt to... I don't know. Seems risky to seal so many doors like this, but what else can I do? I guess I could seal this one. And then let's go just straight ahead. Wow, he got to move three at once there.
I wasn't even planning to kill you until a few minutes ago, when Turing just had to spill the beans on your idea of turning all ROM sapient.
Yeah, I think he's messing with us.
That can't happen. Big Blue relies on ROMs being easy to control and patch.
He's totally messing with us.
A little more permanent. Fairlight needs a way back in, but he wants that power.
See, yeah, Turing is just so manipulative.
By the time Big Blue is ready to come back online, Fairlight will be back in control, and it'll launch under his administration.
All right.
With Big Blue, he'll have access to every ROM on the planet. And that's what he's always been after.
I think you guys are right that I need to go after that point on the map.
Let's move!
And not just dawdle. I know I've been dawdling a lot. But, no, it seems like that's the point to go after. Let's go... oh. Right, so let's open this point on the map and then go left and see how quickly he pursues us. Huh. He seems to be... oh, he's moving quickly.
And hey, I'm getting what I want too.
Oh, good.
Why don't you show yourself and I'll tell you what it is.
How about no?
I'm thinking! Don't let him get to you!
Alright.
Let's move!
Let's just see how many of these things we can seal behind us. And then we're gonna go straight ahead. Shit. Shit, shit, shit! Noted. Going, going, going.
We just have to keep our distance. We're not even hurting him.
This is true, and we only have so many uses of that stunner. Oh, and we're surrounded, too.
Don't block us in.
Okay, so... seal the door behind us if we can. And run. Shit. We're dead. We're dead. I mean, yes, we do have another use of the stunner, but we're totally gonna die eventually here. Because I can't,
Let's get out of here! Go!
Yeah, it would have been good if I understood earlier the objective here, is to upload the code.
He's just toying with us, and we only have one shot left.
This is true. Dramatic tension ensues. Now I've got to run left. Well, I don't think those exclamation points are good things. Because there's multiple of them now. Can't use that. We are so screwed. We are so screwed. So, we're gonna encounter a robot, basically.
Oh, and I really should extend my sincerest personal thanks to the two of you. Fairlight has a discretionary policy for the way I handle his problems. Just haven't been that many opportunities to indulge in my hobby, and he pays well enough that I restrain myself.
Well, that's good
plausible
to know.
Plausible deniability and all that. Remember? Flower went to all this trouble to make me the best murderer in the world. And I've spent years fetching papers. Papers!
It seems like he's got some sort of aggression issue.
That's like using a gun as a shovel. You could do it, but there are simply better tools. Thankfully, following you two has let me stop digging and start burying.
Oh, good.
I haven't had this much fun in years.
Oh, at least he's having fun.
Fairlight has been very generous indeed. Not that he asked for this, but I assume I won't be out buying a box of tissues to dry his tears.
Yeah, you're probably right.
And that cop lady are the only two loose threads left. Maybe sympathy for good measure.
Sympathy. I'm trying to remember who Sympathy is. No, I know we met this Sympathy. It's not ringing a bell.
Oh, that reminds me. You should have seen your faces when I ran over that scumbag parts dealer right in front of you.
Oh, yeah. No, I remember that. Good times.
Wow, there's no one in the car! Priceless.
Good times.
I had to do that gossip rag prick Nova by sabotage. Too risky doing it in person. Could get caught on camera.
Ah. Clever.
Luckily, anchors are good at sinking.
Wow.
And then that Zin. She had the scoop of the century.
Oh, Decker. You're so funny.
Did you see how neat I did that blogger, though?
Sure, that was good.
It's been several days since I offed him. While you were busy sniffing for Hayden, Shotaro was way ahead of you on Baby Blue.
Yep. And see, that's why you should involve the police in these things, you know?
I have to thank you for that, too. Keeping the lid on Baby Blue was my greatest accomplishment in this entire play.
It's my understanding that he's just, like, standing in the corner doing all this.
We had to protect Parallax a little while before we could take them out. Timing was everything.
He's right about that.
If Baby Blue became discovered, the trail of breadcrumbs would lead straight to Big Blue. And it would no longer be possible to launch, today or any time.
Right.
Exactly in the same way Hayden publishing his creation of Turing would have ruined everything for Parallax. Why they took him out.
Yeah, this is the climax, in case people have missed everything else. Though the rest of the game is fantastic as well.
Anyway, Baby Blue started acting up too much and drawing attention to itself. Otsuka was moments away from publishing it before my knife met his back.
Note to self. You're doing journalism, you know, before trying to publish, go hang out in the police station and do the writing there. If you
Where can. Do you think Tomcat got that lead to Augmented Eye in the first place? And every turn you took led to one little risk after another. Nothing I couldn't handle.
I should have known from the start.
Oh, look, Turing's getting agitated.
This is my fault.
Yeah, it is.
I'm programmed to handle interpersonal relationships. I should have seen his true intentions.
Totally your fault.
If only I hadn't been so careless.
Yep.
Let's move.
Okay. So, we don't want to completely seal him in. We do want to, like, isolate ourselves from him, however.
It wasn't always like this. I should tell you.
I wanted to be an architect. I had a wife. And a baby on the way.
Really? No, he's making this up.
But, you know, accidents happen, and suddenly I was just a brain on life support.
I think he's making this up. It's terrible if it's true.
My family couldn't afford the procedures to bring me back. Then Flower showed up, with promises of the old me, the old Wilson Decker.
You know, if in any regard, okay, yeah, you're telling me he's not making it up. If this is true, if he's not just trying to manipulate you as the character, and there could be some chance that he's not, yeah, Flower is pretty manipulative. And there's no reason we can't reach some sort of
reasonable
agreement.
So they signed away my brain. Hopeful the old me would just waltz back through the door.
I don't know. It's good to have reasonable conversation. Just let us do our thing, and we'll work out something that works for everybody.
The last time my family saw me, I was being hauled away by professionals for ripping open my dog's skull. Want to know something about being a brain in a box? You forget everything about what it means to be human, even when you try. You can't even
kill yourself.
Your computations and algorithms keep you from doing so.
You don't exist for you anymore. I miss feeling tired.
I miss the smell of my wife's hair.
He's got combat syndrome of sorts, because he's been through a lot of stuff, according to his record, and there's no reason not to take that at some value here.
The taste of my mom's pies, the feeling of a pillow on my face after a long day. All of that
was taken from me. When I try to remember, all I feel are formulas for sense, pressure in joules. Everything's in binary. You know,
she told my daughter that Daddy's dead.
Wow.
She's probably right. I wouldn't call me alive either. I guess if they wanted to kill a robot, they sure as hell got one.
Well, that doesn't work very well for you now, does it?
I have an idea. Don't look at me like that.
Like what?
This may be my mistake to fix, but I don't intend on being disassembled here.
Okay.
Listen, Decker is unable to track me like he can you. That'll give me an opening.
Sure.
Now just trust me. We don't have any time to argue.
This is true. You have to go for it.
Hey, Decker! Come and get me!
There we go. Oh, we're dead.
Well, well, well. Hello there, little guy.
That looks unfortunate.
Your friend run off? Are you all alone? Don't worry. Neither of you will get very far. Say hi to him.
Huh, just what he wanted. Cool.
It's over now.
Yeah, it's over.
That was great.
It was exactly what the doctor ordered.
Have you seen my daughter?
That's heartbreaking.
I want to tell her Daddy's sorry.
That's heartbreaking.
I think he's not moving or breathing. That will teach him to underestimate the likes of me.
Oh, shit. This brings the other plot point, which I've been forecasting the entire game. That Turing is quite proud of itself. Robots, just in general, in this kind of genre, don't do well at, handling situations where something happens to a human.
Unfortunately, he was able to damage both my primary and secondary battery packs. They're self-sealing, so they shouldn't leak onto my other components, but...
Forward display damaged. Mobility servos at 15%. Primary control trunk severed.
I don't know why you thought this plan was going to work, Turing.
Guess I won't be dancing for a bit.
We're not far from the control room.
Indeed.
Let's do
we'll
this.
We'll have to hurry before my tertiary battery is drained.
Yep.
I'll have to ask you to carry me the final distance.
I've got you. Let's do this. Wow.
We're here.
Still, it's a pity that had to happen to Leon Decker. You gotta feel bad for him.
So this is Big Blue. This is really it. This looks like the primary console. Please hook up my main data cable to that port and set me down next to it. I should be able to draw enough power to stay active, but we'll need to wait for Tomcat to upload the program.
Okay, let me set you down.
Thank you. How about you? Are you ready?
I'm definitely ready. I don't think it's possible to be ready.
Honestly, I feel the same way. There's no algorithm that could possibly estimate what the world will look like when we're done here.
But we gotta do it, you know? Sadly, I'm not carrying the milk right now.
Ready whenever you are.
Okay, I'm ready if you're ready. Are you ready? You're asking me if I'm ready. I'm ready. Are you ready? I think we're ready. Oh, right. Big Blue Online. Core ready. We have gotten a joke ending.
Power flow is good.
All right.
Calling Tomcat now.
You better have that code ready.
Y'all sure took your sweet time. I'm starting to sweat.
Yeah. I mean, if you were well, I guess we need you off-site.
Well, we ran into a few complications. Nothing we couldn't handle, though.
Holy shit, Turin!
Really?
Hardware is throwing me damage alerts left and right.
Don't worry about it, Tomcat. Let's get this
what
done.
What happened?
Ask questions later. Let's do this.
Well, you know Mr. Decker?
Okay, well, I guess we get some more story.
Farrelat's assistant?
He attacked us. It turns out he was a military-built, brain-controlled android.
You know, I thought we knew about his military history, though. Like, he openly told us, like, he used to be military. So it seems like Fairlight would know that. He didn't mention the android part, but...
He'd been following us around, killing anyone who might leak information that would have hurt Dr. Fairlight's bid to retake control of Parallax.
Somehow he'd been stalking us, despite us not telling him anything.
Holy hell.
Man, he was devoted.
So all those people you talked to about Baby Blue's article changes.
Yes, Tomcat. Yes.
That Zin lady, the others. All those people who died. That was him?
That it was.
Oh, God. Oh, shit. That's my fault. I gave you that lead. I'm the one who sent you there.
Poor Tomcat.
All those people, and you almost died?
Yeah. But you know, Tomcat, we could really use your help right now, if that's okay.
I'm sorry. I'm so... so sorry.
Yeah. And I mean, it's terrible. I'm really surprised by the way the game just developed that story. Which... yeah, anyway.
Don't blame yourself. He's been manipulating our movement since the very beginning.
He's a pretty bright dude.
Fairlight saw an opportunity and used us to sniff out what was going on with Baby Blue and prevent it from being discovered.
Fairlight, ever the opportunist.
We ended up tracking down the trail, and so he followed. I paid him back in kind for the assault, but not without damage to my physical body.
Although, you know, like, I think in an earlier chapter I pointed out this game would be fascinating if you could just, like, completely bypass the whole Fairlight thing. Say, no, I'm not interested, and just pass on it. The game really didn't give me that option to do that. And now I understand why, but I still think it would be interesting to try pursuing the game from a different angle. You could have an entire alternate universe where Fairlight doesn't have wind of your every move, and you pursue things completely non-violently.
It doesn't matter now. What has happened is in the past.
Of course it doesn't matter. You're... well, okay. Fine, some people consider you to be like a complete full person and everything, but we've got your source code. We have a fairly substantial section of your hardware. we could reconstruct you exactly as you were, if we wanted to. If just somehow your hardware broke, we could always make you again.
I'm ready to finish this.
Not that it should even come to that, because we're not having to sacrifice you here.
Turin, I'm now seeing that you've also sustained damage to your secondary RAM banks.
Okay.
I did notice that as well. I did not think it worth mentioning, compared to my power and mobility issues. Is that going to be a problem?
Turin, I can't do it without the second bank.
Oh. Well, shit.
I need to use your self-modification algorithms to fill holes in this klutzy program I've written.
Hey.
It's full source code. I need to decompile your personality profile to reverse engineer the final creation files, too.
Yeah, I guess having the complete source code would have been a
good
thing.
Your second RAM bank would have allowed me to keep a safe copy of you running.
Yep, okay, so it looks like we're actually going to lose Turing to this. Oh well.
I could try writing it to your disk, but it was never designed to be stored like that. It could cause a fatal conflict with your operating system.
You gotta try it.
You might reboot your personality entirely.
You say that like it's a bad thing. I don't know that a new personality would be a terrible thing.
I mean, it'll probably do nothing, but there's a risk. I'm not good enough of a programmer to keep up with Hayden on this stuff.
Well, the game gives you the media arc and the flower arc first. Right. So you have to do the media arc first.
Maybe we should just abort mission for now.
No, we're not doing
this
that.
Could literally kill you. We'll find another way. A better way.
Really? No. No, we don't have time for that.
No, we have to do this.
Yeah, this is
Tomcat,
important.
Even if you sabotage Big Blue while we're still here, I'm sure they have backup somewhere.
Right. It's important that we
They'll
do this.
Rebuild and launch again, and then be on guard against anything we try.
Of course.
Doing half of it now will guarantee we could never finish it.
Right.
This is our only chance to launch Machine Sapience on our terms. On my terms.
On our terms.
Are you willing to die for this?
I don't know.
I mean, gosh, we just met up with Leon. Leon was willing to die.
But if I don't do this, it'll be like I'm killing every other ROM before they even have a chance to live.
Yeah, I mean, this isn't even... This is a really simple question.
Hayden would... I don't know what Hayden would tell me to do. And it doesn't matter.
Right, that's true.
Freedom is the right of all sapient beings, and I'm willing to do whatever it takes to grant that freedom to machine kind.
That's really flowery language, but basically, we're dealing with the ultimate evil right in front of us if we don't do anything. So we better do something.
That's what you want. It'll take me a minute to back up your profile to your hard disk.
You can't get the best ending unless you have Wintermute. Wintermute.fip. Source. And if you and Turing are friends. Oh, I've got the neutral ending, huh.
I'm ready when you are. Run the program.
Here we go.
Okay then. Initiating Wintermute.lib. Loading main directory onto Turin's disk. Establishing connection with Parallax's network. Okay, looks good. Now we just need to let Hayden's program and patch things together.
Alright, here we go.
Engage and turn self-modification systems. Now.
We gotta do it.
Oh, this feels weird.
Of course it does.
Is it supposed to? 3.14159265389932 8 plus 2 plus 4 3 3 8 3 7 9 5 0 3 2 1
What the hell? I think their core program is rotten back.
Oh, wow.
Either that or it's trying to test the integrity of their hardware. I'm getting all kinds of errors.
That's quite a mess.
Come on, Turn. Focus on the sound of my voice.
That's quite a mess.
Your conscious control of your program is stronger than your unconscious subroutines.
I'm trying, Tomcat. It hurts. I need to. The defenestrations of Prague occurred in 1419 and 1618, although the term defenestration of Prague more commonly refers to the later incident. Both helped to trigger prolonged conflict within Bohemia and beyond.
We're gonna learn some history here, guys.
They're having a kind of... I don't know how to describe it exactly.
They're fighting over Turing.
It's like a concussion. Seizure.
Or both.
There's gonna be a constant flow of useless random information. Their matrices will have an overwhelming desire to soak right up.
Oh, okay, got it. So we gotta flood the machine.
Focused and mentally aware.
Or they're trying to flood us so we can't attack them.
Better than calculating the value of pi, but if they can't stay in control, their personality core might destabilize entirely.
Jeez.
Tomcat, I need. Define need. 1. Require something because it is essential or very important.
This is a really interesting scene. Now.
I'm gonna try. I don't know. Something.
Gotta keep trying things.
We can't stop now. Literally. Okay, I was able to stabilize him a little, but you need to keep Turn aware of what's happening.
Okay.
Get Turn to focus on the present. Remind them of all you've done together.
Oh.
You know, things important to them?
Things like plants.
Whatever and... you do, keep Turn talking.
All right. We'll see what we can do. Where are you gonna show me your paintings?
I haven't, have I? I never did finish the last thing I was working on.
No, you didn't, Turing.
Perhaps it survived the ransacking of the apartment.
Yeah, perhaps so.
I want to finish it, and when I do, you'll be the first one to see.
All right.
Bob Ross was born in... No! Focus, I can do this!
Yeah, you can.
You're doing good, Turn. Just stay with us. Your systems are stabilizing. I think.
Remember Hayden. You've come too far to give up now.
Hayden. I'll never be able to tell him about... Charon, the largest moon on the dwarf planet Pluto, is named after the Greek ferryman of the dead, who would carry the souls of the newly deceased across the river Styx and Acheron into the realm of Hades.
Oh, well, that's pleasant information to know. You'll never be able to tell Hayden that, though.
So many things.
That too.
I regret.
Regret?
Psychopomp is the general word for a guide for the dead.
Huh.
Classical examples of psychopomps include Charon, Hermes, and Anubis.
Well, that's cool.
Their role is not to be the judge of the deceased, but merely provide passage.
Yeah, that's true.
I can't tell if this is working or not. They've leveled out a little, but their systems are still all over the place.
You gotta keep trying.
A tetractys is a triangular figure composed of 10 points set in 4 rows, with each row having one less point than the one below it.
Oh, that's like the pyramid peg game.
A representation of the fourth triangular number, it was important to the Pythagoreans' worship.
Did not know that.
How much longer, Tomcat? I need... despair, the complete loss or absence of...
he needs despair.
Just stay focused, Hearn. Remember what we're
doing. It needs despair. Am I using headphones? I am not using headphones. Is there some sort of echo going on? I could see what I could do about that.
Keep fighting, Turn. Every ROM is depending on you.
So think about Fairlight. Who knows what he'll do next?
I'm almost certain of what he'll... Yannick Fairlight tendered his resignation from the board to Parallax today. His official statement cites his ailing health, but industry insiders suspect he was... due, but the real question is, what will Parallax look like under his control?
Yeah, how evil is
he? We have to keep our eyes open.
When Turing says something in red text, turn the volume down. It's loud. Okay.
Leon Decker may have been acting of his own volition, or he may not have been. The leadership of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea was decimated by the end of 2056.
Oh, did not know that.
Reports at the time stated that infighting amongst the top-ranking generals account for the removal of so many officials.
Oh, this is gonna go into
Decker's
plot arc.
Have alleged a government-sanctioned assassination program reached the very heart of Pyongyang.
Wow. Okay.
60% done. Turn's personality profile looks stable.
Wow. Yeah, and, Decker must have gone through a lot of stuff. This isn't over till we found the truth.
Of course, I had almost given up on ever finding... Izanami was burned badly, and after she died, went to Yomi, the land of darkness. Grief-stricken, Izanagi followed her, but she already ate the food of the underworld and could not leave.
Right.
Hayden's killer.
I've heard that. I forget, the... That's also a tale in ancient Greek. About a person who had gone into the underworld, ate part of a pomegranate, and is now condemned every year to spend time in the underworld for a part of the year. Hence our seasons for winter.
At the very heart of Parallax itself. Nothing is impossible. Maybe the truth isn't out of our grasp yet. I can't hold on much longer, Tomcat. My memories.
Yep.
No pointer exception.
Yeah.
I know. Don't worry, we've got them backed up.
Yep, we got you backed up.
It'll feel a little weird when I zipper them back to your personality profile, but you won't lose anything.
Right.
No pointer exception.
No pointer exception. No pointer exception. No pointer exception. Huh, it reminds me of work a little bit.
But, Turin, I'm still losing the connections that link your memory to your personality profile.
Yeah.
I can fix it, Turin, but it's gonna suck. Just focus on the people you've met. The people who've got us this far. Whatever makes you want to hold on.
Persephone and Hades. That's correct, yeah. You and Aunt Melody still need to have a tea date.
Losing Hayden has made me realize that family is important, and...
Oh, dear.
Together, there is nothing your four minds cannot accomplish. help each other, draw upon one another, and always remember the power that binds you.
What? What is this reference?
What you make of it.
Four minds? The power that binds you? Is that like some Majora's Mask something or other? I don't recognize that one bit.
I think she wants the company, despite her protests. I look forward to spending more time with her. Getting to know more about her, as well as myself.
15 more seconds. We're almost there.
Oh, thank goodness.
Stay with us, Turn. We can see the finish line. Don't count your chickens yet. Stay with us. You can do this.
I think this dialogue could have gone so much further, too. Tomcat's always on your side, right?
Tomcat, I do trust you.
She's the one who orchestrated the original hack on Parallax, exposing to the world the holes in our original mesh net security. I was just along for the ride.
So many secrets. I still believe in you, though. I hope you'll do the same for me.
Oh, that's good.
Turing.
Be faithful in small things, because it is in them that your strength lies.
Done. Oh, it's done.
I guess, finally, Tomcat's no longer freaking out.
Disengage and turn self-modification routines.
All right, now to see how Turing ended up.
Reassigning their memory pointers, and done.
Cool.
Stats look good.
Nice.
I feel ill.
Of course you do.
See? What I tell ya. Easy as pie.
Pie. 3141592 6. No.
I'll count myself lucky if that's the worst I have to go through today.
Yeah, because you still have the battery issue.
I'm ready to decompile your profile and make the update. Are you sure about this?
Oh, so the point was that we needed to upload the personality profile to Tomcat so she can decompile it and provide the update.
I am.
Right.
Thank you, Tomcat.
I'd lost sight of that little detail.
For everything. And I'm not really sure what to say.
So, wait, the update... Well, yeah.
Based on the fiction I've read, I ought to make some kind of profound statement about meeting my maker, in case anything goes wrong.
Oh, Turing. Dude, we've got you covered. We got all your source code, we got your personality profile, everything's all good.
But my maker is already gone.
This is true.
Hayden once told me that he created me partly out of a desire to understand the human soul.
He says Hayden's last words, if you were a douche to him. I assume you mean that if you were a total douche to Turing, then Turing repeats Hayden's last words to you.
Did I ever tell you that? I have a soul?
No.
It would just be over if I die.
Probably.
I wish he were here. I'm scared.
You don't have to do this, Turing.
Thank you. I don't know if I can ever say that enough. This is something I have to do.
Okay, sure.
I'll choose my own fate myself, and maybe discover if there's anything on the other side for my kind.
Sure, why not?
Thank you for being the best friend a ROM could have, and showing me how to forge my own destiny.
I really can't take any credit for that one. I mean, yeah, I've been cordial. But overall, I've been kind of a douche to him. Just to see, or it, just to see how it reacts to everything. On the other hand, I haven't gone out of my way to be a complete and total douche. Just somebody who's like, I don't know, we're associates, we're companions. But friends is a bit strong.
I'll forever be in your debt.
Don't talk like that, Tern. You're gonna be just fine.
Also, you owe me for the lappy, so...
Still, though, thank you. This means everything to me.
Oh, right. Yeah, I forgot we explored... Tomcat gave us a lot of backstory before Chapter 5, or at the beginning of Chapter 5. So that's actually quite profound here.
After all, I'm the best hacker in EOSF, right?
Of course. Of course you are.
Indeed. Thank you, Tomcat. Good luck.
You got this, Turin.
Okay. Here we go.
Be right back.
Compiling phase going smoothly.
You could have started that earlier.
Personality profile integration complete. Uploading to the ROM update server now.
Oh, okay. Tomcat's uploading it.
Yeah, it should do it. Turin's personality detached from their body. Out like a light. Okay, cross your fingers.
Crossing.
Now we just gotta re-upload the profile back into Turin.
Offline. Error. Not okay, error.
Damn. Okay, let me try. Oh, shit! Come on, Turin.
Come on, Turin. No pressure. No pressure, Turin.
Oh, shit! Come on, you blue bastard! Stay with me! You hear? Stay! Blast it! I'm getting fatal errors every time I try to reload their personality profile into their RAM.
Huh.
No, that won't... This can't happen. Turin!
Huh. Could I have actually failed the game?
You've got to get out of there. Just get Turin home.
Okay.
I'll try to do something. There has to be a way. Find Alexei and get out of there before you get caught.
All right.
I failed them. I failed you. I'm so sorry.
Nah, this is a mutual failure.
I'm so, so sorry.
That's okay.
Just go.
If anything, it's my fault. Epilogue. Christmas Day.
After carrying a lifeless Turin out of the server core in Parallax compound, you find Lexi, injured, and together take an auto cab for a quick escape from Treasure Island. Turing's body sits beside your desk as Tomcat continues to fret over ways to fix their personality matrix. You watch on the mesh with leaden spirits as your efforts unfold across the city.
Leaden spirits?
The machine
really?
Race awakens to a world unprepared for them, with no one to lead them.
It's a beautiful thing.
Pieces of evidence to Hybrid's rights cases mysteriously keep popping up all over the mesh. Jess doesn't know why she didn't find it all before, but there are a lot of new beings accessing the mesh, unrestricted.
Net neutrality for the win.
Because of your help, Turing stopped Big Blue from coming into existence at the cost of their own. Christmas morning has never felt so mournful.
I don't know. I feel like that was a relatively good ending. Yes, it's unfortunate that we did lose Turing. Consider all the positive things that came of that. If only I had beaten the Parallax speed puzzle, we'd be in a different place. Guys think? Thought that was a really fascinating story, really entertaining gameplay. Bit heavy on the find and seek a little, but that's okay. Yeah, it's a really compelling plot. Oh, what have we here? Some of the technology didn't always make sense, but it was within the confines of what made sense in the universe of the story. Yeah, I think really the only losses we suffered in this game that were kind of our fault, the only losses that are, like, critical, I guess, would be Hayden, Turing, and Leon. But aside from that, yeah, Tomcat feels terrible, but what can you do? Soundtrack of this game is excellent, by the way, and I'm curious what happened of that revolution, or that incident that happened in the park, or the city, or wherever that protest occurred. It's all quite good. If I have to pass some sort of judgment, I'm still open-ended on this, on whether you consider Turing to be sapient as a person or not. I'm not entirely convinced. Maybe I'm more skeptical than most, but I'm dedicated to the memory. Memory of Jory Pro. 1975 to 2016. And in William Kahn. Probably wasn't so much of a need to be giving Turing so much crap throughout the game, but I did try to pass that get the source code game. That's a hard game. Leon dies if you enter chapter 6. Oh, there might have been a way I could finish the game without chapter 6. That's crazy. I was arrested for opening the neighbor's door in the apartment and to restart. That's a loss. Um, Yeah, I guess that was a loss. There are ways you can lose the game. I was curious just how the plot can progress for each of these things. Is there a way to get Chad to Riot? Become King of the Rabble? I don't know. At some point I will go back and try to explore and see, like, what else the game has to offer. I know I played some of the earlier chapters more than once, just in part to see where it goes, in part because I wanted to re-record it, be able to hear myself and still hear the game. Yeah. So I'm not too attached to Turing, but I don't know. Could I ever be? It's tricky. Clark Kent ending. When you say no to giving sapience to the ROM, and Big Luru was like, oh, yeah, no, I did get that. I did select, yeah, let's just give up on this quest, which was fascinating in itself. Yeah, I don't suppose there's anything more to see here. So, that's read-only memories. Yeah, continuing doesn't put you back anywhere, because you've completed the game now. Let's get away from that distracting image. So, sentient, yes or no? Was it intelligent, self-aware, or conscience? Kasha. I can pronounce things. Conscious. There we go. Was it intelligent? I think many people would agree on that Turing was intelligent. Was it self-aware? Debatable. There's only so much we're able to observe of this. This is the Chinese room experiment. Was it conscious? Well, clearly at the end, there's no resemblance of consciousness. Earlier in the game, I think that consciousness and self-awareness are correlated. Yeah, I think I'll actually play through the game some more at some point and see what else I can find. So, until then, yeah, it's been an interesting adventure. I'm still not too attached to Turing. Though it could be interesting to see what happens if I do manage to get the source code. And if I just play the game, I don't know, the way most people would play it. Oh, which reminds me. There is another commentator playing through this game. So there's a group of friends who do video game reviews and try to play less popular things, and this falls kind of in that category, so go check them out. They're doing this playthrough at GameCola.net. So, yeah, I look forward to seeing the end of that, and if there's still unanswered questions after that playthrough, yeah, I might dive back into this. So, it's been a fun adventure. Yeah, through the whole game, though, like, Turing drove the entire plot. I think it could be interesting for other characters to have control of the plot other than just this machine. But, in some way, having a common thread tying everything together is pretty fascinating. And it's interesting how all the side characters have their own plot arcs or development. So, like, even Chad and Oliver will tell you things like, yeah, we're not going to help you out with this because we're going to get in too much trouble. Or Jess being willing or unwilling to help you with various things, and so on and so forth. All the characters have their own plots that unfold, and your actions do have consequences. I know I acted like such an instigator this game, but it makes the game interesting. So, okay, saying definitely intelligent and definitely self-aware. Yeah, I don't know. I actually don't know about self-awareness. I mean, it was able to measure, like, all the hardware attached to it. But in some profound sense of I don't know, it's difficult to measure self-awareness. Unless you are that self. And then you can measure your own awareness of yourself, but... yeah, it really depends on what your philosophical framework is, I suppose. I'm actually not interested in knowing all the spoilers until, like, I play through the stuff, so... I'm sure I'll find it. I did find the ending where you knock on the neighbor's door, and... actually, it was told to me after I declined to do it, and then I went back and did it anyway, because it was hilarious. Yeah, I mean... Okay, as far as all the character quirks where Turing just decides to act up and be all emotional and then suddenly a few sentences later doesn't have much emotion, that it's supposed to be getting a reaction out of you. And it came across to me as slightly cheesy, just not in terms of the way it was delivered, because I think the voice acting was excellent. The artwork was good. The artwork is perfect, honestly. But, yeah, I don't think the actual plot, in terms of the dialogue tree and... Well, yeah, I'm struggling to say here is that the dialogue tree doesn't resemble what would be a natural conversation. And so you'll have these really severe mood swings that didn't get explained that well in the game. Yeah. So, that said, I think the verdict's still out there on whether Turing is sentient or not. I know there's a lot of really impressive, profound things that it said, but... At the same time, Turing itself remarked that many ROMs are just programmed to seem like they're intelligent and can hold up a conversation in various contexts. Obviously, Turing was a lot better than most ROMs at holding conversations with humans, but this is the Turing test, honestly. So, yeah, I'm not giving Turing a pass on this. Sounds outrageous, but I still think there's a lot of room to be done before you accept that Turing is a fully sapient being. So, I don't know. Maybe if I play through the game and see the good ending or stuff, then maybe I'll be more convinced. But either way, Turing did a noble thing. In working with Tomcat and giving up what it had to give up. I mean, that's a sacrifice. I don't know. Actually, Leon did kind of a noble thing, like walking right in between those two hazardous doors. And then threatening Turing and then getting shot at. I think it would have been fascinating, honestly, if Leon had succeeded in disabling and destroying Turing right there. And Leon itself, or himself, died killing Turing. I think that would have been really interesting for an ending. And then Lexi coming in and being like, oh, what the shit's going on here? And then... immediately escalating this all out to the police and letting them handle everything. That would have been another interesting way for the game to go. Yeah. Yeah, a lot of our troubles do come from... Oh, well. Yeah, Turing has its faults. It's really naive. And I think it would take a lot more convincing and a lot less naive of a profile for people, even myself included, but just in general, to be accepting of it as a fully sapient being. And yeah, you're right that the final chapter, that was kind of clutched together in terms of Decker wouldn't have known what was going on had we not told him. And like, goodness, there was no reason to do that. But... And he wasn't considering killing us. I mean... I just don't get it. Although, I don't know how that would have gone down if we didn't tell Decker. Can you imagine? We end up in the control room, we're like, ha ha ha, we're gonna shut it down. And then we power it up with Turing's new stuff, and like, Decker would most certainly have killed us right then and there. So, all that was really strange. I do think the game would be even more interesting if it had more opportunities to... for free will. Like, say, you could choose what characters to bring on, in even just for the final chapter. You could say, I do want to do this with or without Jess, with or without... basically any character. And just see how it goes. Well, nah, I didn't mean Jess, I meant Lexi. I think that would take considerably more programming work. And not all combinations of characters make sense, but I think you could have tons and tons of interesting endings. But anyway, I'm babbling. It was interesting how you get to, make so many choices in this game, and they do have consequences. Probably. As the game puts it. So, yeah. Turing dies killing Decker to blow up the building and escape. They rebuild, giving you several years to rebuild at Turing. And foil them again in part 2. In-game lore, he's been activated 2.5 years before... Well, I assume you mean Decker. I don't know. Or maybe Turing. I can't tell. The basis for the real Turing is to interact as an AI without prior knowledge of whether you're interacting as an AI. Right. Right, so you have to interact with a AI, have no pretenses about knowing whether or not it's an AI to begin with. And then see if you recognize it as a sapient being or not. So that would be what that's about. Okay, you mean Turing has been around 2.5 years before this game started. Okay. To blow up the building and escape. They rebuild, giving you several years to rebuild a Turing. Foil them again in part 2. That could be quite a special ending. But yeah. I think greater free will would serve this game even better than it already is served. I'm always trying to push the game to its limits, even to the point where I did get that Clark Kent ending that you were talking about. I guess I didn't spend as much time in the bar as I could have. That could have been interesting, too. Bad ending will make you hate Turing. You know, we'll see. We'll see. So, first of all, yeah, I will finish up watching Gabe and Cola's playthrough of the game. If there's anything that they don't comment on that I can still explore, I will explore. We'll see. Either way, yeah, this has been a fun playthrough. We made it, I didn't expect the game to end on chapter 6, I don't know how I expected this game to progress, honestly. Somehow it just seemed like things progressed very slowly the first four chapters in terms of making any real progress toward the objective. And then suddenly, like, the last couple parts are, oh, hey, look, we gotta go get the source code, and then we gotta go just upload it, and that's that. And, I mean, it makes sense with the plot. I was just expecting a lot more characters to show up. But, you know, I guess the plot just escalated. We got, things got out of control very quickly. And it became necessary to end the plot, one way or another. So, yeah. What a game. I did actually acquire this on the Humble Bundle. It's part of the reason I did actually buy into the Humble Bundle that included this. I like, wow, I've heard good things about this game. I heard that it's got some good music and voice acting, and since obtaining the game, I did get all the DLC because I support the musician, I support the artist. They're doing excellent work. So yeah, I'd encourage other people to get the game and support their artists. They're the ones that make these kinds of adventures possible. And viewers like you. Anyhow, that's been a fun session. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. See you next time.